Hi YouTube family!
My name is Elysia English.
And I'm Philip English.
Welcome back to our channel. Today, we are starting to do a few projects that we're gearing up to get ready for fall. Fall is about a week away here where we live. We are just starting to tackle a few things on our to-do list that we do every year at this time of year. Clearing out our garden. We worked really hard all year building some raised garden beds, which you saw on our channel. If you missed the video, check the link above. Right now, we have an abundance of produce that has now grown in our garden. Mom has already planned all her projects and what she wants to make with it, and we're going to show you an update on our garden and a few other awesome tips that we have during this video. I'm so lucky that we have gorgeous white hydrangeas outside the house. It was a dream of mine to have hydrangeas, and they're actually quite pricey to buy at the garden nurseries. And when we moved into this house 6 years ago, they were almost completely dead. They weren't even identifiable as hydrangeas. Well, I found out what they actually were supposed to be and learned online just by following some instructions on Google on how I could save these hydrangeas that I think had been neglected for many, many years. So luckily for this tip, I've been able to salvage these hydrangeas, and 6 years later, this was my biggest abundance of hydrangeas that we've ever had on the front of the house. And I'm going to say thanks to my tip that I found online about cutting them back before our first frost. So in about a week, I'm going to be cutting down all of my hydrangeas about 18 inches from the ground and cut off all the stalks. But if I'm going to do that, I'm going to be tossing a lot of really nice flowers that could be dried and kept inside. I can't use this many, but there's definitely some people in my town that will probably want some, friends and family. And so today I'm going to start my first batch of drying. So to dry the hydrangeas, all I do is fill a jug or a vase about 3/4 of the way worth of water. And then I'm going to cut some stalks of some pieces that I want to keep, put them into the vase, and when by the time that the water actually evaporates, my hydrangeas will be nice and dry and I'll be able to keep them all year round. At least until next season when I have some more beautiful ones to dry again. So I'm gonna cut off a few clippings. I always know that it's time to cut my first ones to dry for the season when they start turning just a little bit brown. I try to catch them before it gets too brown or I have too many brown flecks, but right now I'm about maybe a couple days just ahead, but this browning, I don't wanna pick those ones. But there's still quite a few heads of the hydrangeas that are all green, like this one here, which would be a perfect candidate to pull off to be able to dry. So I'm just going to use my garden tools here and be able to cut off any of the stalks that I want. And I'm gonna go for as many green ones as I can. And I usually will take off the bottom leaves here so that I don't have a lot of leaves in the water because those are just gonna mold. So I'm gonna put this piece in.
Don't hang up. Can we be friends again? I give up. I know how this ends. Might sound strange, but I'd give my life for you. Nothing's changed. I just ran away from the truth. One of us makes a mistake. We work our way through the heartache.
Now I'll just wait for the water to evaporate inside over the next couple of weeks and my hydrangeas will be nice and dry and crispy. Sometimes people spray them with hairspray, but there really isn't any need to add any chemical to these. The smell of these always smells so nice inside as they're drying and there's no need to put anything else on them. Just letting that water evaporate will crisp these up and you'll be able to have them in there for quite a few months inside. I kind of keep them till they get too dusty and then I'm happy to throw them out and wait for next season to bring in more fresh ones. So think about what you have in your garden and what you can bring in to bring some life inside your space so you still have that nice cheeriness of having some of your living things you've grown outside inside during the colder months. It always keeps us cheery to have flowers in the house. So I think this is perfect. I kind of love that they turn a little bit green this time of year rather than staying white, but you can also do this when they're white earlier in the season, but I like to take some later on. So we're gonna head in the back now and show you what our garden is looking like. Every season, Philip and I grow about a 40 by 40 foot garden. This year we had the huge tiny studio home built, the huge tiny studio, that sounds really funny. This year we built the tiny home studio and so we didn't have as much space to be able to grow this year, not knowing exactly where everything was going to go. So now we decided to build the raised garden beds, which were really working out really well for this year. So we wanted to test out a few things, test out those garden beds, and then next year go back to our huge garden space. So we're really happy with what we actually got and what we produced this season. So we did cauliflower and broccoli, and our cauliflower and broccoli is both ready right now.
I'm pretty good.
I fed you today. This is actually our second harvest of broccoli this season. We already took a bunch and made some delicious things with those. But I have some gorgeous cauliflower heads that are ready to come out right now. And if I don't pick them now, over the next couple of weeks, they'll start to flower. So I'm gonna pull these today. Oh, it's so strong. Don't eat me. I'm gonna eat you. Oh, it smells so good. So fresh when you pull it right from the garden. So we got some pretty good sized cauliflower heads. I think this one's actually smaller than the other ones. And look at how nice and healthy this cauliflower is. We will definitely enjoy this. This is our first harvest, so we were able to get a second harvest of the broccoli. And our second harvest is actually growing a little bit different, a little more flowery, I guess you could say.
Yeah, they're
than
done.
Our first harvest. We so this is the this. First year we've actually had a second harvest come through. So maybe I've left it too long now, but I think we can still probably enjoy it. But our first florets that we got off were incredible, and boy, were they delicious.
They were, they were so delicious. So
yeah, I'm going to pick the rest of this broccoli. You can see it's starting to flower a little bit. We just had a couple really cold nights, so hopefully we didn't lose this, but we already got enough broccoli that I'm thrilled with the first harvest anyways. I wasn't expecting to get a second. So this part of the garden doesn't look so glamorous. We actually had all the rainwater pull all of our carrot seeds all the way to the one corner. And then our girls, Nova and Finn, figured out how to get themselves up into this raised garden bed, and they laid on top of all of the carrot tops. Basset hounds, good thing they're cute. But we did plant some onions and garlic in here, and I'm not sure that we got them in the ground early enough to be able to have really full-size onions. So I'm gonna try to leave them for a couple weeks longer if I can, since they're in the ground. And I'm really curious to see if any of these carrots have actually produced anything. We haven't had the most success here with carrots in the past, even before basset hounds laid on them. You can see we've got some different kinds of onions. Okay, I'm gonna try to pull up one of these carrots. I'm just trying to find one that I can, are you ready? I'm gonna just try. Oh, the top, there's a carrot! I pulled the top off, but there is a carrot in there.
Ooh, I'll eat that one.
I was so curious if they were doing anything because we've never had carrots really produce carrots. Oh, there's a huge one right here. Can I pull this big, big one?
Yes.
I can see how huge it is.
No!
Biggest carrot yet!
That's such a perfect carrot.
I didn't even get the tops. Look at...
Oh, that's beautiful.
Okay, I'm super excited about this. Our Dayton loves carrots.
Yes.
He would eat them with every meal if we let him.
Yay, what a harvest so far. What else
do we have? Okay, look, we have a ton. So this is actually our third harvest of peppers this year. Mom has already come and taken a whole bunch of kinds, made chili sauce and a bunch of other things with these. She actually separated all of them and we labeled them into baggies so she could do a taste test at home. One of them she called burn your mouth hot, so we must have mislabeled one of them. But we have about 12 different varieties of peppers growing and we're planning on using them for several different projects. But there's a few more that are almost ready here. I think we definitely have some jalapeno peppers are ready. We have some sweet peppers. This one is purple. Can I pick that one now?
Yeah.
Okay, this one looks amazing. And then we also have, I think, some Hungarian wax ready. Another Hungarian wax. Got some really nice ones, but this year we grew a lot more varieties. Usually we pick about three or four and then kind of roll with it. But this year, since we were testing on our new beds, we kind of just picked a whole bunch of different starters and went with it. And I'm really happy because we got an abundance of peppers. Oh my gosh, there's so many. Look at how many are still on this plant. So many more to come. So fun. Look at how big these are. We have also been gathering tomatoes over the past couple of weeks. Again, Mom has gone home with a few bags full of tomatoes, but as our season is now changing to fall, we're noticing that the tomato plants are starting to brown and crisp up a little bit on the underside, which tells me we've got to get this last harvest picked over the next week or two before we get a lot of frost. But I can see so many ripe tomatoes and perfect timing because Mom has some tomato sauce planned for the weekend. So we're gonna get all of the tomatoes picked for Mom. So I'm gonna see how many we can find on this that's ripe right now and ready. But I can see some gigantic Romas and some huge, what ones were these ones called? There's a massive tomato right here.
You're in the tomato jungle right now.
I'm in the tomato jungle, but there are so many tomatoes. Look at this, watch. I'm gonna have it all in my hair. Oh,
Wow. Romas for days under here.
Oh my gosh. Oh, I'll bite into one of those.
Right? I'm going in.
Go in. So many delicious tomatoes. Oh, look at all the cherry. I have to eat one of the cherries.
Okay.
Oh, switch one. Oh, look at this one. Oh, I just want one I can eat in one bite here.
Look at how many tomatoes.
Oh, this one. Right,
look at this.
Look at this. This one's going in.
Done it, done it.
Oh.
The camera's fuzzy.
Holy.
There's so many. Oh, I can see some huge ones. I need more hands.
You always said you wish you were an octopus.
Look at how many there are.
Holy, you ain't kidding around. I can see you over there.
Oh, I dropped one in the tree.
Oh, no.
It's okay. It's going to be tomato sauce.
Oh my gosh. I made a thud. That's got some weight to it.
Wow.
Oh, one might be leaking on you. Wow, hon.
I'm making it all the way around the peppers. Oh, yeah, that one's leaking. Oh, there's so many more, but I don't know how many Mom wants today, so.
Yeah, look at how many there is.
There's a lot. Look at them. There's these big four here.
Holy. What a harvest.
This is like our third time gathering bags full. And 60 tomatoes and a few solid peppers.
60 tomatoes and
a few solid peppers we got today, and cauliflower, broccoli. We'll probably get a few more carrots out today because I'm going to be tempted to make some nice heated up carrots later.
Dane's gonna love you forever.
Wait till he sees how big they are. So we are so happy with the results of our garden. We hope that you enjoyed today's video. We're going to leave you with an inspirational quote that we've kind of been following all year round, and that is that the day you plant the seed is not the day that you eat the fruit. So do something today that your future self will thank you for. Think of a goal that you have, set those goals, take baby steps even on how to get there, whether it be big or small, but just remember that planting seeds now is going to help you later.
Not bad.
Not bad.
Not bad. YouTube family, we love you.
See you on the next episode.
You're good.
Delicious. Cheers, characters.